Hey guys, I'm back. Today I'm really craving dumplings. So I was going to do another real loose version of Bon Appetit's recipe of pork dumplings with a skirt. It sounds really weird, but just wait, hopefully this all goes well and you'll be able to see exactly what that means. I'm absolutely not going to be making dumplings from scratch when I have these. These are just some Ajinomoto pork gyoza. I just got them from a local shop. So instead of doing what Bon Appetit says and making your dumplings from scratch, I'm gonna use frozen. Hopefully it still turns out nice. First things first, let's make a dipping sauce for our dumplings. We have black vinegar, some soy sauce, a little bit of sesame oil. Last but not least, we're going to add a spoonful of chili flakes. I'm going to make some charred broccoli as a side. I like to make sure I'm getting enough vegetables in because I think it's very easy to get stuck in the potatoes as a side every day kind of lifestyle. And then that gets finished with some minced garlic and some lemon juice squeezed on top. So I'm just gonna get the lemon and the garlic and the ends of the broccoli cut off in the meantime. And then I'm gonna start making the dumplings. For the slurry, which is going to make the skirt on the dumplings, we're going to need 3 tablespoons of rice vinegar, which mine is looking kind of empty, so we'll see how far we get. 2 cups of water, 4 teaspoons of all-purpose flour, 4 teaspoons of cornstarch, which I don't have, but I do have potato starch, and a little bit of salt, and that's it. I'm gonna grab a whisk. I'm going to make an assumption that this is what it's supposed to look like. I mean, it's just essentially some flour and starch and water. I'm very weary, I guess, to believe that this is going to make a crispy anything. So I think right now I'm going to plan for failure. And if that means that I just have to make some dumplings that were frozen, then so be it. All right, here we are on my very tiny counter space. We have 2 pans, 1 is cast iron, 1 is nonstick. The nonstick is for the dumplings, the cast iron is for the broccoli, each with about 1.5 tablespoons of oil. We're going to get the cast iron ripping hot, and then we're gonna just let the broccoli go in there and char with a little bit of salt, and then at the very end, we'll put some garlic and lemon on it. And then I'm gonna start heating up this nonstick so we can put these gyozas on. And here in the back, we have our very murky looking skirt slurry thing. Oh my god. Okay, I'm like a little panicked, but let's try and keep the faith. Don't have a lid, so another pan. All right, now let's open it. This is what not to do. Oh my god, ow. Oh my god, okay. Just kidding. Okay, take 2. I turned down the flame to like low. And if this doesn't work, then straight up we're just gonna do it the regular way, but fingers crossed.
broccoli is almost done, we're going to take our garlic and some lemon juice and give this a stir. So straight up, this is not doing what I thought it was gonna do. So I'm gonna scrap this plan and we're just gonna eat some frozen dumplings because this is not. Oh wait, maybe we'll give it like one more minute and then try to like flip it out or something. Cause something's happening. Dude, I'm scared. How do you do the, advise me really quick, how do you do the flip? Doesn't like the plate have to be bigger than the pan or something?
Technically. What about using that thing over there?
What? Okay.
You sure?
No. Is it hot? Y'all, not even close! Oh my god. This is round two next to round one, so I'll say that we've definitely made an improvement. Right? Okay. Oh, this one's pretty. No, it's not. I'm lying. This one's not pretty. It's just big. Oh, okay. Call it gourmet.
I think I'm a glutton for punishment because I really want to give this like one more try. The last one like kind of worked, so I'm having a little bit of faith. So I poured off some of the water in the skirt mixture. So I guess it'll be a little bit thicker. So let's try this for the third and final time. Pour that in. Please, oh my gosh, please. I'm gonna turn this down really low and we're gonna really hope that this works. Honestly, this kind of is looking worse than the other two. It looks like a big, slimy, slippery, slurry mess. So we're just gonna hope that it all gets brown and crispy. I don't know. I mean, at this point, really, all you can do is laugh. No. Oh, but it does sound crispy. Yeah, no. I'm gonna write this off as a no, but I am still gonna eat it. So this is the evolution of what happened. We have two burned, beautiful gyoza. We have some that like kind of worked-ish. And then we have this monstrosity that looks like literal skin. But we're still gonna eat it. Yeah. I definitely think I should have left the amount of water that was in the mixture alone. But broccoli looks good. So that was a disaster. I really think I got a bit too cocky in the last round saying, oh, let me try and take some of the water out. Like I was really monitoring it. I kind of had a quasi thing going on with the second round. And then I just got a little bit too full of myself. But that's why we do this, to see if we can take a real loose version of a recipe and if it still comes out successfully. This obviously did not. I am wondering if it was a problem with the cornstarch versus potato starch. I only had potato starch. I didn't think that they were that much different. Yeah. Like if you like it, feel free to subscribe. I am hoping that it won't always be like this. I think the last video and this one were a little bit ambitious, so maybe next time I'll just make bread or something very simple, but I guess that wouldn't be so entertaining either if it was just too smooth, right? So I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.